stand here. The permanent secretaries of the Federal Ministry of Labour and Employment, the Ministry of Education, representative of the Ministry of Finance, Executive Secretary, National Investors Commission, other representatives of the Office of the Accountant General and the Project Office of the Federation, President and NLC, Nigerian Labour Congress, the President of ASUU, and other officers of the union who are here with us. I have to welcome all of you to this meeting and wish you best of the season and Happy New Year as we enter into this deliberation. This deliberation, I hope, will be short. Short in the sense that we have done a lot of work since the last adjourned. And from the look of things, from what we got back as our feedback on the government side, we hope that after this meeting, we'll have good news for Nigerians. On that note, I want to welcome you and wish all of us very fruitful deliberations in this meeting. Thank you very much. Call you back. Immediately we'll finish our deliberation.
Thank you, distinguished colleague. We appreciate your presence. Please kindly allow the meeting to proceed behind the door. As I said, we'll be called back. Please.
I want to repeat emphatically that a few days ago we were with Mr. President. On the strength of the ultimatum we issued, that this meeting has to be reconvened in the interest of our members and the general public. And we graciously made this possible. We are happy for it, that he has done that. But then it's very important that I say this. In the interest of openness, sincerity of purpose, that this meeting is made open. The reason is this. I have always said, on behalf of my members, that in the past few months, we've not really known exactly what is happening and what have kept our members at home. Government will tell us one side, ASUU will give us a very different story from what government have told us. And that has informed why we have requested that we want to be part of this negotiation committee. Even though it has met heat, very strong rocks over the past few weeks, you know, leading to heated arguments. We are not part of. May I plead, Your Excellency, that the media, the fourth estate of the realm, who represents the general public, who are the eyes of the general public, who are the ears of the general public, are allowed to be part of this proceeding. The reason is, they will be able to give us appropriate reportage of whatever it is that is happening in this proceeding. Then secondly, as a leader of Nigerian students, like I mentioned earlier, we are the ones that are building the bronze. That we will be able to go back to our members and tell them this and this were things that were discussed, and of course, this is the resolution. Because the interest of our members to us is utmost, which is to go back to classroom and continue their learning. So I plead once again, on behalf of about 80 million Nigerian students that are studying both in Nigeria and in the diaspora, that Your Excellency allow the fourth members of the fourth estate of the realm to remain here to observe this proceeding, and of course, the leadership of the National Association of Nigerian Students, just for the interest of sincerity of purpose. Thank you.
My own children are here in school. Oh, they are Nigerian universities. I don't have anybody abroad. So whether you have people abroad or you have people here, it's one collective goal. We want to keep our university running. We want to get our university up to standard so that when you eventually graduate, your certificate will be worth it. Evaluation nationally and universally, so that you can take a certificate from Nigerian University and work anywhere in the world, UK, USA, Canada, anywhere. So we are all partners in progress, including you, because we are also in a discussion that will not make for you guys to pay or your parents to pay what is astronomical or what they can afford. This discussion is tailored into a kind of subsidizing university education, which the current government is already doing. And so I crave indulgence, even in the National Assembly and legislature, anywhere, you do what is called technical sessions or executive session. So this is our own executive session. Thank you very much.
Honorable Mr. Sir, repeat what you've said. But may I say this?
Yeah.
That even issues of national importance
are discussed on live television. Issues that borders on the nation, nationhood, and of course, members of the general public are discussed on live television. The last time we were here, this same thing you said was said to us as to why we should excuse you. And after that, the next thing we heard was that ASUU staged a walkout and of course addressed a press conference that they are not even going to return to the negotiation table without thinking about us, our organization and our members. And this same thing was said some few weeks ago at the Federal Ministry of Education, where the Honorable Minister pleaded with me as leader of Nigerian students to excuse them for a technical session so that they can resolve the issues. But the issues yet were not resolved. And today we are here. It's been said again that we are going to make progress. We are not asking for too much. Nigerian students are not asking for too much. They just want to know the cross of the matter. They want to know exactly what is keeping them at home. If it's about what we are hearing in the media, we are reading on the pages of the newspaper, we want to confirm. We, that are their leaders, will be able to convey to them that this is what is being discussed. And of course, the members of the fourth estate of the realm will help us in disseminating the appropriate information. Instead of being fed with whatever, if after this meeting, you may choose to tell the media whatever you like yourself. After the meeting, ASUU may also choose the path to relate to the fourth estate of the earth. And that is why we are pleading that please, you allow us to observe this process
We are not, Solomon. We just trust us, let's finish. We'll bring you in and you talk to us. Thank you.
So we'll gently brief that.
Yes.
You don't disconnect it, sir.
Welcome back. You know, I promised you it would be a short meeting. We didn't need to keep vigil again like the other times. Yes, so we had to report to you and to NAMS on their request. This meeting was very fruitful. And we made progress. ASUU delegation was very understanding, very cooperative. And we trashed out the items on the agenda very swiftly. A particular note is the fact that ASUU have fulfilled their own side of the bargain in terms of NUPENCO. NUPENCO is the pension fund administrator that the company that ASUU had floated to take care of pensions of people in the university system. The pension regulators, PENCON, had asked for certain
conditions to be fulfilled, the earlier gave ASUU a temporary license, and now that license was to expire, and ASUU had submitted all the documents and fulfilled the conditions needed for them to get their license. So this meeting resolved that we will now mandate Ministry of Education to get in touch with PENCOM to make sure that the permanent license is issued to ASUU as soon as possible. As soon as possible. With that also, with the issue of state universities, if you remember at the last meeting, we agreed to set up a consultative committee, sort of a standing committee, to be interacting with the governor's forum and authorities in state universities to make sure that funding is not a problem in state universities and that the material and human resources needed for their functioning is adequately provided. In that wise, we formed an initial seven-man committee, which today the meeting enlarged to accommodate the committee of pro-chancellors of state-owned universities, making the number now 8. This 8-man committee will be liaising with the governors' forum, and if needs be, individual governors who own state universities as the need arises. That's on the issue of state universities. Salary shortfalls in tertiary institutions, especially universities. The Ministry of Finance and the Office of the Accountant General have provided us with evidence that on the 31st of March, 31st of December 2018, before the expiration of the recurrent aspect of 2018 budget, that they remitted the sum of 15.389940335.71, which is 15,389,940,335 naira 71 kobo. This is to accommodate payment of shortfalls in all the tertiary institutions that have been PICA verified. PICA is Presidential Initiative on Continuous Audit. So they have shown us that evidence. Again, on the issue of end allowances in the university system, they also showed us evidence that Mr. President has approved for the sum of 20 billion to be used to offset the outstanding arrears on the 2009 to 2012 audit verified earnings in the university system. This money is being worked on and will be released to ASUU as soon as the processes are completed. We also discussed the issue of revitalization and the fund there. the General Town Administration entered into an agreement with ASU for revitalization with a payment of 220 billion annually for the next 6 years, starting from 2009. Of course, that agreement has not been fulfilled, and government being a continuum, this government says we are going to look for sources of funding because the university system is still a very critical area of our development. And therefore, we again, like we did the last year, reiterated our stance that we're not repudiating on that agreement. And we have offered ASU some token to show good faith, and that amount is known to them. To take it back to their members and then report back to government. We visited the issue of visitation panel that has been taken care of by Minister of Education, and ASU is quite satisfied. And we have it from Ministry of Education on good authority within the next fortnight. The visitation panel should be rolled out to go and look at the university system and check what and what have been done there rightly and wrongly. These are the major issues we discussed, and ASU is supposed to take back the contents of this meeting, the resolutions of this meeting, and the areas of agreement, and the areas where they need to do further consultation back to their members, and we expect that they will come back to us. We are telling them that we need them to get back to us so that we can roll out an agreement with CBA that will be agreeable to everybody, at least, God willing, by Thursday they should be able to do so. Wednesday, Thursday. Thinking, and that's the request of the meeting, so that the universities can be reopened for people to go and finish their exams and take more lectures and move to the next classes. Thank you.
Thank you, Honorable Minister. All other protocols will be observed. We have had an extensive session looking at all the issues, and just like the Honorable Minister said, there are issues that will require further consultation at the level of our union before we can make any pronouncement on our stand. In view of this, the government side has promised to reach us as soon as possible with a written proposal on those areas which we need further consultations. And when we receive the proposals, we shall treat accordingly and we'll get back to the appropriate quarters. Thank you all for listening. Thank you.
I have come in Daniels and Babu, your family, president of the National Association of the Student. Let me start by appreciating you for reaching this compromise with our lecturers. And it's a good development. It's better than when there was no negotiation, when there was no discussion. And these are members who feel glad that negotiation has continued. And of course, there is possibility for them to come back, or for all of us to go back to classroom.
But let me say, for the sake of record, that the issues that you have mentioned to us here, which I am privileged to represent Nigerian students and hear on their behalf, and a lot of them are watching us live because we are streaming. You've mentioned about six items, which starts from Dubenko, State University salary. Dubenko is a pension for our lecturers. Then the second one is a State University staff. The third one is a salary shortfall, which you said the federal government has graciously approved about 15 billion naira, which is to be disbursed. And then the fourth one is end academic allowances, which you have also said, and I think the ASUU president has not contradicted that, that the federal government has approved 20 billion naira, which also will be disbursed. The last one is a visitation panel, and finally, the revitalization of the university environment. You agree with me that out of all of this, it is only one that directly affects us, which is the revitalization. The Honorable Minister, sir, may I beg you on behalf of Nigerian students that having enumerated these 6 points that you have read to us as your resolution, make Nigerian students to know exactly what you have approved for this revitalization. Nigerian students want to know, they want to hear by themselves. Just as you have mentioned these other figures here, 20 billion, 15 billion, let it not be communicated to us the other way you mentioned. Please, the Honorable Minister, Nigerian students want to hear what this is. Then finally, that our struggle wasn't against ASUU, it wasn't directly against government. Ours was to make sure that the interest of our members is protected, which is to go back to classroom. Margaret Thatcher once said, leadership is leading the people to where they don't want to go to. But when they get there, they say, this is where we ought to have been. A lot of my members have been insulting me before the issue of the issuance of the 2 weeks ultimatum to both parties, which includes the federal government and ASUU. And again, let me say it for the opening time. That informs why Mr. President invited us to the villa to discuss. And of course, we reiterated our problems and challenges before him, which he addressed. On Friday, Ted Ford was directed to release some funds. And today we are here. I must say it, even though a lot of effort is out there to discredit us, to discredit us, to discredit my leadership. But I don't care, so long as the aim and objective and the interest of my members are achieved. I don't care about the tantrum. I want to say finally that Nigerian students are glad that we are making headway. But like our earlier appeal, please, Nigerian students also want to go, because this is the only area that affects us directly out of the 6 points you have made. Please, let us have this information. Thank you.
Because we are supposed to be working for the progress of the university system together. Nevertheless, some issues must be put in proper perspectives. It is not about welfare of students versus the welfare of lecturers. We have an agreement. Even when a sum of 20 billion is mentioned, you have to view it against the backdrop of what the total sum is about. When we go about throwing or banditing figures around as if all matters concerning academics have been addressed, yes, the universities are about lecturers and students. We agree. And in that agreement, it should not be seen as if lecturers are self-seeking people. If you don't have well-motivated lecturers, you cannot have a university. And you cannot have quality education that you can be proud of. We don't want to join issues with students. But at the same time, students are not party to our agreement. When you talk of 20 billion against how much, that is very important. If you are talking of vitalization, if they mention any amounts to you, before you can properly contextualize it, you must look at the whole figures involved. In 2012, a comprehensive assessment of needs of Nigerian public universities was carried out. The reports are there. That is what we are pursuing the implementation. So when we talk about Revitalization is not just about students. It's also about academics, about facilities, about laboratories, about libraries, and so on, including those states. So let us not look as if students are here to protect their own interests. University lecturers are defending their own interests. It is not students versus lecturers. And we don't want that impression to be created outside this place. Thank you very much.
I'm happy you're talking the way you're talking, but the president of ASUU has captured what I wanted to say. The 20 billion on end allowances is a portion of an aggregate amount of about 100 and something billion, 105 billion. The government would have wanted to pay off on a 100% basis. But because we can't afford it, education and finance and God has put it together, and we offered that. And the remaining will now be paid in tranches. We pay in tranches. Then on revitalization, a committee was set up to find how we can get the revenue. But what other sources? Because the budget cannot carry it. And that was why a seven-man committee was set up, was held. And sources of revenue were identified. Those sources have been sent to Mr. President for approval, because some of them will need an executive bill that will go to the National Assembly to amend already existing act. That is in medium term and long term. So the token we have offered is on the short term. And if you remember, we had a 20 billion on revitalization, 10 billion into two. So whatever we offer now and again will go into that same basket and be distributed. So, but before I said that, I told you that your lecturers were very understanding, and that this discussion was smooth, swift, unlike the former times. And I attribute it to the fact that that former times, we didn't understand ourselves, we were new. They were new to me, I was new to them, and he was also new. But we have gone this pathway before. That's why we made substantial progress today. And I can assure you that people will go back to school very, very soon. Very soon. We're working towards seeing the universities reopen by this weekend. Thank you.
Nigeria, I still believe in you, 'cause you've got all it takes to be a greater nation. I still believe in you, 'cause you've got all it takes to be a greater nation.